Inputs to Risk Inventory and Control, Risk Management Plan. Ang isang risk management plan daw ay isang plano sa sakuna, sa paparating na sakuna. Halimbawa, sa pag-attend ng mga seminar para malaman ang kung anong gagawin pagdating ng sakuna. 2. Number 2. Risk register contains outputs of the other process. Identified risk and owner risk response trigger and warning signs. So daw po yung mga nilalaman ng yung output or process na na-identify na problem and also the owner kung paano nag-response and trigger and warning sign. Approved change request. Number 3. Approved change include modifications such as to escape schedule, method of work or contract terms. This may often require new risk analysis to consider impact on existing plan and identifying new risk and corresponding response. Ito daw po yung discontents yung mga na-approve na change kagaya ng suspect schedule, etc. Dahil sa new approved change, kinakailangan ng new risk analysis para malaman ang impact nito sa darating na executing plan. Number 4, work performance information. Project status and performance reports are necessary to risk monitoring and control risk. Ito po ay ang nilalaman kung ano ang status at ang performance para sa pag-monitor ng control ng risk. Output risk monitor and control. Risk registry. Number 1, risk registration updates. Risk register is updated to include outcomes of risk assessments, audits, and risk reviews. Update may affect risk probability, impact, rank, response, etc. Actual outcome of risk and of risk responses that becomes part of the project file to be utilized on future project. Ito daw po yung nagkakameron nito ng para malaman ang costume na risk or assessment na nireviews natin. Number 2, corrective action. Corrective action consists of performing the contingency plan or workaround. Workarounds are previously unplanned responses to emerging risks. Workaround must be properly documented and incorporated into the project plan and response plan. Ang nilalaman po nito ay ang pag-perform ng contingency plan sa pag-perform nito na kailangan ay documented. Kailangan pa ipipicture natin. Number 3, recommended preventive action used to direct project towards compliance with new project management plan. Ito po ay ginagamit para sa compliance sa management plan po. Project change request. Result a requirement to change the project implementing contingency plans or workarounds frequently plan to respond to risk. The result is issuance of a change request that is managed by overall change control. Ito po ay ginagamit sa pag-comply ng plans, kinakailangan ng change and project plans para sa pag-respond sa risk. Number 5, organizational process assets updates. Information gained through the risk management process are collected and keep for used by future projects. This include templates for risk management plan, probability impact matrix, risk register, and lesson learned. Ito daw po ang mga info na nagagather at kailangan ikip sa atin sa mga future project. Number 6, project management plan updates to the project management plan as a result of approval of requested change. Ito daw po yung kailangan nating i-manage. Risk monitoring tools and techniques. Risk reassessment. Project risk review at all team meetings and major reviews at major milestone. Risk ratings and prioritizing may change during the life of the project. Change may require additional qualitative or quantitative risk analysis. Ito daw po yung mga dapat nating pag-aralan pagdating ng sakuna. Ito po yung mga kailangan nating malaman para ready tayo sa sakuna. Risk audits. Examining document the effectiveness of the risk response planning and controlling risk and the effectiveness of the risk owner. Ito daw po yung mga nagpaplano no, para sakaling may magdating na sa kuna is ready tayo. Number 3, variance and trend analysis used for monitoring overall project cost and schedule performance against a baseline plan. Significant deviation indicate that updated risk identification and analysis should be performed. Ito daw po yung gigamit para ma-monitor ang pangkalahatang project cash, and this you will be able to indicate updated risk identification. And number 4, reserve analysis. As execution progresses, some risk events may happen with positive or negative impact on cost of or schedule contingency reserves. Reserve analysis compares available reserve with amount of risk remaining at the time and determines whether reserve are sufficient. Do po ang mga risk events na pwedeng maging negative, positive ang reserve analysis na nagsisilbing ginagamit para ma-compare ang natitirang available reserve. Status meetings. Risk management can be addressed regularly by including the subject in project meetings. Ito daw po yung para ang status meetings ay dito pwede pag-usapan ng about sa risk management. Dito po natin lahat mapag-uusapan. Security risk education. Security risk education is conducted to develop security awareness among employees of the company. It should cover all employees regardless of rank or position. Ito daw po ay ginagawa para mabigay ng security awareness para sa mga employees at para sa lahat ng employee kahit anong rank position. Objectives of security risk education. Number 1, guidance for all supervisory or executive levels of the organization. Ito po yung para mag-guide ang lahat ng isang organization. Number 2, a mandatory indoctrination on security for all new personnel before their assignment to their prospective jobs. Ito po ay para sa mga baguhan bago sila ma-assign sa kanilang mga kanilang trabaho. At number 3, development of high degree of security consciousness among the selected supervisors and other key personnel in a program that should be continuing and supported by top management. Ito po yung para makasama ng high security sa company, supported ito ng mga top management. Number 4, a down-the-line security program aimed at instilling consciousness and dedication through various methods of instruction such as through demonstration, lectures, motivation, suggestion. Ito daw po yung mga nagbumunghay para matuto. Ito po yung mga nagle-lecture o mga nag-demonstrate sa isang seguridad, para sa seguridad. And number 5, to let all employees force inform that they all belong to the organization and that non-awareness to the security program is tantamount to disloyalty. Ito po yung para ma-inform lahat ng employees at ang walang alam sa security program ay kinukonsider wala ng disloyalty company. Number 6, data program is also to develop discipline, loyalty, and belongings. Ito po ay para ma-disiplina tayo ng ayos sa ating mga sarili. Phases of security risk education. Initial interview. It is the first contact of the prospective employee wherein the interviewer determines the suitability of the applicant for employment through his give answer on the different type of question being conducted. It is in this stage where the interviewer may starting providing the necessary information as to the overview of company security policies and the same time on the employee accountability and corresponding penalties that could result from violation thereof. Ito daw po yung mga dyan yung may mga itatanong yung interview na set of question sa interview natin para malaman natin kung suitable ba siya sa isang job na inapplyan niya. Number 2, orientation and training it is in this stage, where new employees receive detailed presentation of personal security policy, usually handouts or employees' manual are being distributed for reference. New employees also requested to sign acknowledgement that they have been aware of the existing company policies and will able the same. Ito daw po yung orientation and training na ito. Ito daw po yung parang nag-held ng meeting para malaman yung mga about sa company, like mga policies and everything, or kaya may manual na para basahin na lang ng isang employees. Number 3, refresher conference. It is designed to remind employees of the company about their responsibilities, review the guidelines and policies, introduction of new policies and regulation, and a moment of getting employees feedback about the company policies that is being implemented. Ito daw po yung refresher course, parang same lang din ang orientation and trainings, which is para ma-aware sila ng mag-responsibilities nila sa isang company and also ipaalala sa kanila yung mga policies. Number 4, security reminders. A phase that employs an indirect approach of educating the employees, such as posting security poster and distributing flyers. Ito daw po yung security reminders para ipaalala sa employees yung mga need gawin to secure the company in a way na bigyan sila ng flyers. Number 5 is security promotion. It is the act of emphasize the importance and role of security achieving the company goals and objectives. It involves securing employee cooperation and support. Ito po yung security promotion na dito daw na-emphasize ng company na important ang security in their company para ma-achieve yung goals. Yung goals, syempre, with the help na yun ng mga employees. Security survey and inspection. The information pertaining to the one of the most important security service offered to a head of office is the conduct of security surveys and security inspection. Every unit chief desire a security system that will reduce an absolute minimum the possibility of espionage, sabotage, and compromise of classified information on his office or unit. Since there are many security countermeasures to be considered, heads of office should utilize specially trained personnel. If the efforts of espionage and sabotage agents and other criminal elements are to be negated. Security is extremely complex program. The objective analysis of an office head security program by security survey inspection personnel can be of great assistance in determining the efficiency of any established security program. Ito daw po yung magkakandak tayo ng survey, no, para maiwasan yung mga sabotaheng gawa sa isang company. Kailangan natin palaging mag-survey at mag-inspection para hindi matuloy ang mga gawaing masama. Security survey. Security survey is an estimate of the security standard of a unit is conducted to enable the responsible officer to recognize and evaluate security hazard and determine protective measure necessary to the prevention of sabotage, espionage, subversive activities and other criminal acts inimical toward the interest and or mission of the unit and or command. Ito daw po yung mga survey na para sa seguridad para maiwasan ang ating pagsasabotay sa isang unit. Ito daw po yung survey ng seguridad para magagamit natin sa mga senior facility manager or industrial planner na pagtukoy ng uri at lawak ng mga kontrol sa seguridad ng pasilidad o mga lugar. Purpose of security survey. The security survey will be used by the senior facility manager or industrial planners in the determining the type and extent of security controls for the facility or areas. Each type of physical security survey will include the determination of the security level of the facility and security evaluation. Threat assessment, which address the criticality of operation, the vulnerability of the facility or area, and the probability of compromise of the personnel or properly contained therein. Ito daw po yung mga survey na gagamitin natin sa mga facility para para sa manager or industrial planner na pagtukoy na uri at lawak ng isang lugar.